sleepy as you seem. Stay away, don't worry.
Alrighty. Well, welcome to Wednesday. First of all, that's always a good thing to say. And sorry, we had some sort of weird internet outage just a minute ago, and it knocked everything off. So I think we're good now. I see people coming back on, but my apologies for that. So let me get things situated here. I'm going to wait just a moment. I don't want to start too quick. I'm going to give people just a moment to come back on. Right now, let's see, how are we doing there? Okay, we're about halfway there to what we had. So we have a lot of things tonight. As you know, we have a fantastic guest tonight. I will introduce that fantastic guest in just a moment. We're going to go through some talk. If you saw the promotion, some talk on some collaboration videos. If you have not seen those, you'll be amazed at what you can do. And this guest will explain how to do that. And then we're going to... I keep saying that guest because I'm not saying her name yet, but you already know her name. So Liz, when Liz comes on, then she's going to, then we're going to play a little treat. She is going to teach a song and then do a cover. And then she's going to stick around, I believe, on the Facebook side of things and answer questions that you might have and say hello and be friendly to y'all. So, all right, so the count is coming up. So with that, I am going to go ahead and do this. So Liz Brinker, if you saw the promotions, like I said, has been involved in music long, long time. Pretty much, she said, since day one. First, she was in dance. She was in the choir. Then she went into musical theater. Then she discovered the guitar, and she played the guitar for many years. And it was then, after all those years, that she discovered her true passion, her true love, which was the ukulele. So now she teaches guitar, she teaches mandolin, and she teaches primarily ukulele from home. So if you're interested in that, she can answer questions in the Facebook chat after her appearance. So, and the one other thing that you'll also see is she makes these amazing collaboration videos also, which we'll learn about shortly. So with all of that said, let's bring on Liz Brinker, welcome.
Hi, everybody. Nice to see you.
Hi. I know it's always strange to be in a room by yourself with no audience, but they're clapping. So welcome, and thank you for being here very much.
My pleasure. Nice to be talking to somebody.
So I've gotten to know Liz over the past couple of weeks. Liz is probably the most organized person I've ever met. If you saw, we did a promotional video, or Liz did, a few weeks back to talk about this, you know, her coming on tonight. So we talked and I said, hey, Liz, I think it'd be kind of cool since you're doing a little session on collaboration videos. What if you did a promo in that format? And like 2 hours later, she sent it to me completed. I'm like, wow, this is going to be great. So thank you for being so organized. That's awesome.
Oh, that's one word for it, organized.
Yes. So it's fantastic. So
might be a euphemism for.
So anything to say? So we're going to show some things, but anything you want to say before we roll into the first little video we're going to play?
Well, I want to thank everybody for tuning back in after the technical snafu. That's always frustrating to be anticipating something and for it to go away. So thank you for coming back.
Yes, very much. We appreciate that. I'm raising your volume just a little bit, Liz.
I want to say hi to my mom. She's out there. Oh. Eleanor. Everybody say hi, Eleanor.
Hi, Eleanor. Okay, so let me real quick go over to this. Oh, there we go. Now that's both of us on the screen. Okay, so hi, Eleanor. We're glad you're here watching your daughter. She's very talented, and we're about to see some of her work. So why don't we go switch over to that? Liz, is that okay?
Of course.
Okay. So we are going to switch over to that real quick. Let me find that. And You will see these collaboration videos. Now, collaboration videos, as you'll see, can be with yourself, it can be with others. So here's some of Liz's finest work, and here you go.
You went to school to learn now what you never, never knew before.
So I noticed a couple of things, and then I will let talk a little bit about how this is done. One, I mentioned before that you're extremely organized, so that shows, because that takes a lot of planning, because you have to know when you're coming in at the various parts. But I'll let you talk. But the other thing I noticed is the outfit. That must take a lot of planning too, because no, you've got five different outfits you're wearing in that video, so.
Well, you might be familiar with women tend to have more than one shirt.
It's fantastic. And the comments, I mean, people are just loving that. Tell us about that. How you first kind of, ventured into doing this, and then really kind of the technique you use.
Well, I have a friend who's my friend now. Let me start again. I have a local friend named Diane Poole. Hi, Diane.
And she has in the comments earlier saying hi
to several of her friends, including a high school classmate of hers named Michael August. And you may or may not know Michael, but he has he's a wonderful musician and has his own Facebook page called Harpo's Chatterbox Cafe. And he got after me to get the acapella app because I have iPhone. It's available for iPhone. I wish it were available for everything, but it's only available for iPhone, iPad, And I resisted for a long time. And so I would send him a video that I just took on my phone, and he would import it into his a cappella app and make a video with himself and other friends. So when the pandemic started and we were all staying home, I finally just paid money. And it wasn't a lot. For a year's license, I guess, to use it on the basic level was about $50 in March, last March. And it has paid for itself just in entertaining myself. It's paid for itself so many times. And do you want me to show you a couple things on my phone, Greg?
Yeah, absolutely.
But for the Michael Jackson song, the Jackson 5 song, that came about because I take part in a ukulele underground subforum called Seasons of the Ukulele. And I'll put that in the chat when we're finished here. Seasons of the Ukulele. And every week there's a different theme, and they call that a season. And I did that one for a theme that was called sequences. Had to do with sequences and 1, 2, 3 ABC. That just kind of fell into my brain. And I was lucky enough to, the Jackson 5 was my very first live concert. I was 7 and Michael still had a high voice and went, boop, 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 boop. So it was very exciting. My mom can attest to that. She can put it, she can, you know, back me up here. All right. So I'm going to have to get rid of this one and start again. So let's say you're looking at your phone screen. Tell me when it looks not glary, Greg.
That's okay. Just a tiny bit, one way or another. Just angle it.
Yeah, I'm trying.
Not up and down, maybe left or right, just a tiny bit.
Oh, okay. Oh,
yes, that's probably good enough.
That. Sorry, guys. Okay, I'm failing.
Let's
move away from the light.
Yeah, just keep going. I think they'll.
Sorry.
They'll get it.
Will they? All right.
Yeah.
All right. So this icon right there that has the two little microphones, that's a cappella. So I'm going to open that. I'm going to try to open that. There we go.
There it is.
So then it comes up to this main screen like this. And if you want to record, you hit the same thing, the little microphones at the bottom of the screen down there. And it'll come up like that. And there's one I was working on today. You might notice I have the same shirt on. I do have more shirts, but this is... For this particular song, I like this. I wasn't real crazy about this this collaboration I did today with myself. I needed a bass player and a percussion person, but it was for Seasons of the Ukulele on Ukulele Underground, and you have only a short time to get everything done. So I'm going to say I want to record new. There's a red bar here. Record new. I'm going to touch that. New project? And this is always the scary part. And I say, yes, new project. So it should go to a main screen like this. And I always have to choose this one, which says basic, because I didn't pay the big money. I don't even know what the big money would be. So I'm going to choose basic. Tell me when this is too much detail, Greg. And then you can choose your template. You can choose this shape, which is kind of like, what do they call that? When it's taller than it is wide, that's
Portrait.
Portrait. Yes, you can choose this portrait mode. You can choose... a perfect square mode, and all different shapes in the square mode. So if you page back and forth, you can have more people or more squares anyway, whether it's with other people or not. I think for Jackson 5, I just used 5 up and downs in the rectangle shape. So I went to the rectangle, like a TV or movie screen, and then I think it looked like this. So I chose a template. I'll give it. Oh, then you have to give it a time limit. So I'm going to say 10 minutes. I always choose 10 minutes, even if the song's only 2, because it doesn't really matter. Just choose longer than you think your song's going to be. And then it'll show you the screen that I just did for Michael Jackson. So there are 5 little holes. You see that, Greg?
Mm-hmm.
Is that visible?
Yep, it is.
Am I freaking you out? I'm a little close to this. The 50-plus-year-old woman shouldn't get quite this close, I don't think. But okay. So let's say I touch the middle screen, and so that's where I would record. Is right there in the middle screen. Do you see how it's getting you?
Yep.
Yeah. Let me see if I can put you in there. I don't know if I can. Anyhow, so are there any questions in the chat about how to do this? You need to wear an earbud. You plug in your earbuds and not AirPods. AirPods make a latency thing happen. So you need to use an actual tethered earbud that goes into your phone. And I just wear, or headphones, but I like to have one ear exposed so that you can hear yourself. And in the other ear, you're getting whatever parts you've already recorded. Does that make sense?
Yep.
You know, because.
So yes, it does make sense.
You've had a little experience now.
So a multi-panel thing, and so you sing the first one, and then the next step is then you either pass it to yourself or you pass it to someone else, right?
Exactly. And there are different ways to do that. You can send it through Facebook Messenger, you can send it via email, you can send it via text message, smoke signal. No, I'm kidding. There are several different ways that'll give you options to send it, and you have to decide whether to send it as a collaboration link or not. And that's always good to remember to send it as a collaboration, because otherwise they can't join in. Now, a lot of people, when they use Acapella, they go through the app more. You'll get a notification, oh, someone wants to collaborate with you on something, and you have to give them permission on something you've already done. I haven't done a whole lot of that, but I know people do, where some stranger will just come in and do a part on a production that you've done. So if somebody's done that to one of my songs, I don't know, because I don't really go look around in acapella to see what is going on in the acapella world. But I bet there's somebody listening to your show that does do that.
So just when I was interacting with you on this, I mean, I see there's a lot of resources on YouTube, like how-tos on this, but also you're going to stick around. So if people have some questions about this, they can ask questions in the comment in a little bit.
Absolutely. And I have a friend actually who lives in I believe it's Kentucky, who has a good tutorial of her own. Her name's Gail Herrera. And she'll be mutual friends with a lot of the people that are probably online right now watching your show. And she has a really good tutorial on YouTube. But there are several on how to use acapella app for iPhone on
And
YouTube.
the so that's awesome, and it really is. I've seen it, but had never been involved until I met you. And to show everyone out there kind of how us mere mortals can do this. I worked with Liz and a couple talented folks. Well, you'll see them in just a second. But if you're ready, I'll s click over to that, and we can watch. And we did this, and again, we were not together at all. I've never met Liz in person. I've never met Michael August either, or the bass player. And you will see all that in just a second. We'll give thank yous to them in just a moment. But I'll switch over. So this is all done remotely, one person at a time doing their part, and then you can end up with something like this. Here goes. One, two, three, one. I know why you're lonely,
and I know why you're blue.
You're lonesome to see him,
and you long to see her too. We're
We're not
not
in
in
love
love
with
with
each
each
other,
other.
we're
We're
in
in
love
love
with
with
our
our
best
best
friends.
friends.
So
So
let's
let's invite
invite
them
them
over
over again.
again.
We've
We've
talked
talked
it
it
over
over
and
and
over.
over.
And we know it's not right. We should stay away forever, but
but we're
we're lonesome
lonesome
each
each
night.
night.
Yes,
Yes,
we
we
stay
stay
away
away
for
for
a
a
while,
while,
but
but
we
we
know
know
in
in
the
the
end
end
we'll
we'll
invite
invite
them
them
over
over
again.
again. Thank Michael August on the dobro. He did the solo there. Franco Long on bass, and of course Liz, who's with us tonight, playing ukulele and doing vocals. So thank you so much. It's a blast. A lot of fun. So
check it out, the app,
really
check out
was
the videos.
Greg, and I noticed how self-deprecating you are about your voice, and I just want it to go on the record in the comments here. You have a beautiful voice. Right, everybody? Greg, you sound really good. You have a nice bass slash baritone. Did you have any choral singing experience, or
no.
have you sung publicly
no.
other than on your show now for a full year
yeah.
almost?
No, about 3 years ago I had, no, probably 2 years ago, I had enough to drink at a bar that was hosting a ukulele jam, and I got sort of coaxed into getting behind the mic. So that was really the first time in public.
Wow.
So you were great and patient, and Liz walked me through this whole thing, and that really is just to show you that you know, mere mortals can do it, and it's a lot of fun, and the output can be, you know, it's great. It's a lot of fun. So thank you.
I will say that the first time you make a project, it really does help to be in communication with someone who's done it before, because Greg, you'll remember there comes that moment where you have to push, yes, I want to start a new project.
Yeah.
And you think you're going to erase the work, but you just got to jump off that cliff and push yes to say, it'll look like you're going to start something completely new, but it's to add to what they've sent you. So that's a little bit of a design flaw, in my opinion.
Probably type in some input, but thank you. That's just a lot of fun.
Yeah, sure. Okay, I was noticing in the chat people were asking about the free version, and correct me if I'm wrong, people in the chat, but it was my impression that you could do the free version of the app up to videos of 1 minute. I think I saw 3 minutes, and that could be correct. But if I remember from my experience, I could only do up to 1 minute, but I could be wrong about that.
All right. And there'll be more questions. So again, if you're joining later, Liz is going to stay on after she finishes up here and chat with you. So you'll be able to ask her anything you want about anything, right? Nearly. Music, a cappella, lessons, ukulele, all of that. All right. So I'm going to switch things over to this.
Oh, yay.
And I will... I have no need to introduce this. It's on the screen, and so are you. So it's all yours.
Wonderful. If you could tip it down just a little bit.
That's right. We talked about that.
That's okay. No, I just want to make sure it's there and that the strum is visible and everything. All right. You may know this song. I love, love, love this song. It's from 1970. And believe it or not, Stevie Wonder was 20 when this was recorded. And he produced it at age 20. I think I may have watched a few too many Gilligan's Island episodes. When you hear about people doing stuff like that, by the time they're 20, it's just like, what have I done? Anyway, he gives credit to his mom for the signed, sealed, delivered line. He was working on the musical part of this piece, and she heard him say it, and she said, ooh, that's good. Signs he delivered on yours. And so that became the name of the song because of his mom. And how I want to start working on this with you is there's kind of an iconic descending line that you'll hear in the piece that starts up on an F. And it can be played single note-wise. And your F note's going to be on the first string or the A string at the 8th fret. And then you take that to the E flat. So I hope you've got your ukuleles. I want you to do this with me. Greg, do you have your ukulele? Okay, so we're starting up on the 8th fret for the F note, and then 2 down to the 6 for the E flat, 1 more down to the 5 for D, and then C, the 3rd fret, and your B flat at 1, open the string for A, and you can be fancy and slide up to F, back up to F again. So again, let's just do the numbers this time. 8, 6, 5, 3, 1, open, 8, one more time, 8, 6, 5, 3, 1, open, 8, one more time, I lied, 8, 6, 5, 4, or C, B flat, A, all right. So you may recognize that line from the song, and you can play it in many places in the song. But if you'll put the chord sheet back up, oh, not yet. Don't put the chord sheet back up yet, because the other way to play this walk down is chordally with chords. So there's an F7 shape to be had at the 8th fret, where you bar the 8th fret, and you it's like you're making a B7 shape at 2. Should sound like this. You have your ukulele, Greg? There you go. Good modeling. Up at 8. 8, and then you've got your middle finger on string 3 on the 9th fret. Okay? So there's your, on top, you've got the F note. And then if you go down and take the F7 shape at 5, which looks like a C7, and then you pick that middle finger up, so you've got an F6 chord. And then you take your first F7 position. Be sure you're covering the C note at the 3rd fret on the A string. And then when you pick your pinky up, you've got two options here. For your next note, which is going to be the B flat, you can either just pick your pinky up and just smash the first two strings in the 1st fret, still keeping that F7 shape, or you can take a B flat 7, which I kind of like. That's kind of funky. Let's just do that. B flat 7 there. And then you go back to just a regular old F, or an F7 not covering the C note. And then back up to F7 at the 8th fret. I know that's moving kind of fast, but I just want you to stick this in your head, all right? So it's when you're going to cover the same descending line, but using mostly F7 chord shapes. So 8th fret, and then you move to the 5th fret with kind of a C7 shape. Now pick up your middle finger. Greg, I don't see you playing. Now go down to your first position, F7, covering the C note. Now take that B flat 7 for the B flat, and then just a regular old F. And then back up to the 8th fret. Okay, so that's enough about the intro. I wish I put that on the chord sheet. You can put the chord sheet back up now, Greg. Thank you.
Okay.
Okay, so let's walk through the chords real quick.
And real quick, so if people are watching it and are blown away by what you just showed, this is recorded. You can watch this back on Facebook. So you can watch this multiple times, and if you miss something or if it seemed too fast, it's available. So.
The wonders of technology will never cease to amaze me. All right. So then we just have a regular F to open with. F. One thing I love about this song is if you look at all the chord shapes, your first finger is in the 1st fret the entire time, or can be, unless you go up and do that chordal or the single note walk down. So if you've got your F, and then the next chord, you just tuck your ring finger in for D minor. And then you just kind of fold them down for that B flat. Oh, you've got an F7 coming up. Sorry. For F7, just go back to your F shape. Add the other two fingers. I prefer that you cover all 4 strings for your F7. The only difference between the usual F7 is that you're just covering that C note on the A string. Yep. And then you have to just fold down to your B flat major. And for G minor 7, just pick up your ring finger. C7 and E flat. Now I'm showing you this E flat because that keeps your first finger in the 1st fret the whole time, but you can always play this E flat too, the one that where you bar 3. That's fine too. But dealer's choice on that. All right. So as for the strum, are there any questions in the chat, Greg? Should I be paying attention to the chat? I'm not paying attention to the chat.
I'd say let's get those later and let's just keep
All
rolling.
Right. I hear you. I hear you loud and clear. All right. So the strum that I've suggested here, and you're going to play whatever you want. Straight down strums are fine. But here's what I've got written down is down, up, 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 down. We're going to do it a few times. Down, up, 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 down. Just I've got my fingers just muting the strings. So I can just practice up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. A couple more times, and then we'll play. All right, here we go. So let's just walk through the first. Let's just play it, and I'll go a little slower than I usually would. All right. So let's just do the single, let's start with the single note descending line. Two, three, four. One more time. Now an F chord. Like a fool, I went and stayed too long. Now I'm wondering if your love's still F7 strong. Ooh, baby, here I am, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. And you can probably hear the descending line would sound really good right there.
Fantastic. No, I like that. I like the walk down a lot.
Yeah, it's kind of fun to incorporate. And when I'm all done, when we sign off, you and I, I'm going to go get a little bit of food and come back because people can't see me eat, which will be good. Maybe a glass of wine, and I'll answer any questions. And if you'd like, I can put the notes for the walk down in the chat if you want me to.
Awesome. Fantastic. Wonderful. Well, thank you.
Why, you're welcome. Let's thank Mr. Stevie Wonder for a beautiful song, wonderful song.
So you have a song to do?
I can if I haven't taken too much time already away from your sing-along. I'm happy to.
7:45. You know, how about if we have... So you've been great, and I've loved working with you, and we want to have you back. I want to have you back, and I'm sure those watching. So would that be all right if we...
Talk about Johnny Carson. So excited.
Would that be okay if we had that cover back when you come back soon?
Absolutely. Yes, that way I don't have to make that PDF we talked about after we hang up.
That's right, because it was a surprise.
I do want to mention, I know that in my promo that I said I was going to be playing covers and originals, and I've used a lot of time with the teaching the Stevie Wonder song. So please feel free to check out my YouTube channel. I made a playlist today of the, I don't have very many originals, but I did make a playlist of the originals I have so far on my YouTube page, because I did put that in the promo, but I'm not going to play any originals tonight. Sorry, maybe next time if you have me back, Greg, maybe.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Well, definitely. No, definitely. So you can find Liz on YouTube. I did it. If you just search for Liz Brinker on YouTube, it'll pop up. You can
Should
go to her Facebook page. That has the actual URL for YouTube, her channel. Either way, but she's easy to find, and there's lots of great videos out there on YouTube.
It's been
So.
it's really fun. It's been such a good pastime for me during this time at home. Really positive.
Well, it's been great meeting you. I hope we can do another a cappella, little collaboration video. Would love to do that.
I'm game.
If you tolerate me one more time. So stick around, folks. In the comments, Liz is going to join you after she gets a bite to eat, and you can ask her anything you want. Liz Brinker, everybody, thank you so much. It's been a blast.
Thanks, Greg. It
All
was
right.
great. See you
All right.
soon.
We will see you soon. Bye. All right, so let me do one thing real quick. All right. Okay, so that was fun. anyway, check out her stuff. She really has a lot of videos out on YouTube, and they're just phenomenal. So, and check out that app as well if you can. I know it's iPhone. I know last time we had a show, we talked about OnSong, and that was on an Apple device. So, these app producers need to be creating apps for Android as well. They're missing half the audience. So let's roll right into this. We have done this one before. This is in the key of D. So originally, a lot of you probably know this from UB40. This is sort of a reggae song back in 90s, maybe somewhere around there, late 80s, early 90s. But it was actually written by Neil Diamond. So we're just going to do a bare, pretty basic. I'm going to do an island strum with a chuck. So it starts out red, red wine goes to my head. And let me start the music. That'll help. Makes me forget that I still love her so. Red, red wine. It's up to you. All I can do, I've done. Memories won't go. Memories won't. I had sworn that with time thoughts of you would leave my head. I was wrong. Now I find just one thing makes me forget. Red, red wine. Stay close to me. Don't let me be alone, alone. Oh, it's tearing apart my blue heart. I have sworn that with time thoughts of you would leave my head. I was wrong. Now I find just one thing makes me forget. Red, red wine. Stay close to me. Don't let me be alone. It's tearing apart my blue heart. Red, red wine, stay close to me. Don't let me be alone. It's tearing apart my blue heart. All right, red, red wine. All right, if you're new here, I say this every time, but we often get some new folks. We do a song or two every time, every week with some percussion. So I start a drum machine, and then we just play along with that drum machine. So I am going to do that now, and you should hear this. Right? So just, excuse me. Again, I'm just doing a basic uke strum, just that down, down, up, up, down, up. So how does the, before we start, how is the mix of the drums and the uke? So if I'm playing, how does that sound? Someone could comment real quick. Last week I heard someone say that the uke was a little soft. Okay. We're a little delayed, so you probably already commented. Good, but out of focus. Is it out of focus for anyone else? You talk about me? Or the lyrics. You might need a bit less drums. Okay. Really? All right, I'll turn that down just a hair. All right, are you ready? With no further delay, here we go. And let me, this is just a little high. I'm sorry I'm doing this. Oh, that's a little better. Yeah, that's a little better. All right, here we go. Ready? A one, a two. One, two, three, four. Someone told me long ago, there's a calm before the storm. I know. Been coming for some time. When it's over, so they say, it'll rain a sunny day. Yeah, I know. Shining down like water. Can't stop, I wonder. sunny day. Listen to that added cymbal. Yes. Devin, you caught that, huh? It's my feet. They're busy. I'm playing cymbals down there. It's quite the production, eh? All right. What is next? Margaritaville. All right. No drum machine on this. Just straight play. I think we're just going to go right into it. I'm going to take these earbuds out for just a minute. All right. Let me stop for just a moment. Look at some comments here. I have not done a good job tonight at looking at comments. Drums are a little hot, Brad said. I probably should have seen that. All right. So you were commenting on the drums. I turned them down a little. I'm so sorry if they were still a little loud. All right, so here we go, Margaritaville. Here we go. Limit on sponge cake. Watching the sun bake. All of them tourists covered with oil. Strumming my four string. On my front porch swinging. Smell the shrimp they're beginning to boil. Wasting a weekend in Margaritaville. Searching for my lost sugar soul. Some people claim that there's a one to blame, but I know it's nobody's fault. Don't know the reason, stayed here all season with nothing to show but this brand new tattoo. But it's a real beauty, Mexican cutie. How we got here, I haven't a clue. Wasting away again in Margaritaville. Searching for my lost sugar soul. Some people claim that there's a wall to blame, but I know it's nobody's fault. I blew out my flip-flop, stepped on a pop-top, cut my heel, had to cruise on back home. But there's booze in the blender, soon it'll render a frozen concoction that helps me hang on. Wasting away again in Margaritaville. Searching for my lost shaker of soul. Some people claim that there's a wound on to blame, but I know it's my own damn fault. Some people claim that there's a woman to blame, but I know it's my own damn fault. Alrighty. All right, so we're going to try something a little different. Lisa, what type of uke are you playing? Were you asking Liz or were you asking Greg? I will try. You might I've already answered that. All right, so we're going to try something slightly different. If you know the song For What It's Worth, stop. Hey, what's that sound? Everybody look what's going down. It's called For What It's Worth, for whatever that's worth. Ba-dum-bum. But we're going to try something a little different here. Let me just get this slightly ready. Yeah. And for this, I will need headphones. So there is this very recognizable part of this song. And it's the part that goes boom, boom, boom. And it's just a single pick. It's, oh, you know, over and over during the chorus. Right? So I will explain this in just a moment. So I've made a, well, let me start. Let me play this here. I made a little loop on a looper. It's not a perfect loop, but it'll work good enough. And basically, so we're gonna stick with this song for a little bit. It's gonna be fun. We're gonna play this little this simple little addition to the song. Then we're gonna do a tiny bit of just solo work, just so you can have some idea that soloing doesn't have to be all that hard. So, if you look at your ukulele, on your A string, that's the one closest to your feet. So, on the fifth fret, so the loop, sorry, the loop you're listening to right now is a D and a G. If you look in the intro, it says D, G, D, G. It's just looping over and over, D, G, D, G. On the D, which was right there, you're gonna pick the fifth fret of the A string, right? So it's here, right there. D, so that's the fifth fret. Then the neck on the G, when the G comes in, you're gonna play the A string on the 12th fret, and that comes in here. Fifth fret. Does that sound familiar? Just over and over. Five. 12. Five. 12. I know. Getting that? That's all it is. Alright, so we're going to work through this song just piece by piece, coming back to that little riff we're doing. Ready? Something happening here. What it is ain't exactly clear. There's a man with a gun over there telling me I got to beware. So I have this looping, and what I'm gonna do, just to tell you, it's gonna sound a little clunky. I'm gonna turn off the looper because the chorus is slightly different. So I'm going to say, telling me I got to be aware. Then I'm going to turn off the looper and just play the chorus. Ready? So it goes like this. It's time we stop. Hey, what's that sound? Everybody look what's going down. And then I turn the looper back on. So if you're interested in the looping, it's actually pretty easy and kind of cool what you could do, especially for stuff like this. Now, if you don't want to go out and spend money on a looper, I don't blame you. But the simple way to do this is just play the song. play D and G for like 3 or 4 minutes on your phone and just record that and then just play it back out loud and then play the picking part with the recording on your iPhone. So? We're gonna take our time on this song, right? There's battle lines being drawn. Nobody's right if everybody's wrong. Young people speaking their mind, getting so much resistance from behind. It's time we stop. Hey, what's that sound? Everybody look what's going down. And then the looper. I'm gonna not pick that. I'm just gonna let that play a couple measures. You don't hear me picking, you can hear you picking and not me. So again, it's the 5th fret on the A string, 12th fret on the A string. Alright, I'm gonna come in now. Alright, here we go. 5. What a field day for the heat. A thousand. Did we sing the song? Did we sing this first? We're gonna sing it again if we didn't. I don't think we did. It's just more practice on that little riff. Alright. What a field day for the heat. A thousand people in the street. Singing songs and carrying signs. Mostly say hooray for our side. It's time we stop. Hey, what's that sound? Everybody look what's going down. Alright, verse 4. Strikes deep into your life, it will creep. It starts when you're always afraid. Step out of line, the man comes and takes you away. You better stop. Hey, what's that sound? Everybody look what's going down. Alright, so now we're getting here, and we're going to do just a tiny bit of solo work here. Alright, you guys enjoying this? I hope so. And of course, Liz, you're harmonizing, that's awesome. Maybe this song we could do. Okay, so when you're soloing, right, we've talked about scales before. And we can do this on other strings, but we're just going to keep this simple. So on the A string, the string we've been playing, let's focus on these frets. And you can write these numbers down or just remember them. We're going to focus on 2, the second fret on the A string, 5, that's the one we were playing before, 7, 9, 10, and 12. And if you record yourself and do this, you can listen and hear which ones sound right and which ones don't. I mean, if you play that 4th fret, just play the 4th fret. Oh, it's like, wow, that does not sound right. Somehow your brain just knows that. So, 2, 5, 7, 9, 10, 12. Got those? Well, now just sort of tinker around with those chords, ready? That's all the time we'll spend on that part, but all you're doing is picking notes in the scale to the beat of the song, and it's almost like you can't do wrong. So, sort of fun. So I would recommend that. Record you just playing this little riff here. You know what I'm gonna do? I will record like 10 minutes worth of this riff. Not this riff, this chord progression, D and G. I'll record 10 minutes of that over and over and over, and I will upload that to Dropbox. And then you can download that and play it, and you'll have this riff, and you can do just what we were doing. So, kind of fun. Alright, so we're just going to end on this little outro here, and I'm going to stop the looper and come back to just playing, okay? We better stop, hey, what's that sound? Everybody look what's going, we better stop, hey, what's that sound? Everybody look what's going, we better stop. Hey, what's that sound? Everybody look what's going. We better stop. Children, what's that sound? Everybody look what's going down. Rose, we are in the key of D. The key of D. Alright, so hopefully that was fun. I had a blast when I was just tinkering around with that. So that's the only reason we're doing that tonight. Because I had fun with it. So I hope that was fun for you. All right, so this, we're going to come back to a drum machine. Oh, I can leave these in. Let me unplug this real quick. Okay. And I'll be right back. I'm going to change the drum machine. And then we'll do that. Just one moment. Alrighty. Donna Draper, you had fun? Good. I'm glad you had fun with that. So melody, that's a good question. I don't have a baritone. I don't have a baritone, but you're picking D and A. Those are the two notes you're picking. So if you look up online, just the baritone fretboard, and just look at the baritone, right, that last string. It's not an A string on a baritone, but if you look for notes D and A, those are the two notes you're picking for that. So that should be real easy to find. There's probably a real smart person on the chat that could probably tell you that if they play baritone. All right, so we are going to play drum machine on this. Hopefully we're pacing this tonight's show well enough. I know it's 8:16, but you know we don't end at 8, that's for sure. All right, here we go. I'm gonna look at something very quickly, one moment. Okay. Probably know this by Rod Stewart sang this. I want a two. A one, two, three, and. Lawson, you're the nicest guy. I still am anxious to get up to Tennessee to see some of you folks, because this has been fun for sure these Wednesdays, but I am anxious to meet like live people. All right, so what else do we got here? Pearly Shells. We have never done this one here. And the rule is, when we do something for the first time, you gotta lower the bar. Don Ho did this, Burl Ives did this, but it's Pearly Shells, you know, from the ocean. Real easy, easy chords. Well, there is an E in here. All right, so people hate E. There's a lot different ways to play E. One way is if you bar the fourth fret and put your pinky on the A string of the 7th fret. That's an E. Kind of an easier one to play. But if you really don't want to struggle with an E, as you might know, just play E7. So I'm going to play E7 on this because I figure many of you are going to play an E7. So I'm going to do that as well. So this goes just to the slow island strum. We'll start back over. Pearly shells from the ocean shining in the sun. It's a nice slow island strum. Yeah? And there is a G minor in there, so take a look at G minor, because that's not one you play every day. So look at that G minor. All right, so I'm going to start. And if you don't know the song, you'll catch on real quick. It's pretty much the same chorus and verse multiple times. So easy enough. Are you ready? Here we go, Vamp on D. Pearly shells from the ocean shining in the sun, covering the shore. When I see them, my heart tells me I love you more than all the little pearly shells. For every grain of sand upon the beach, I got a kiss for you, and I've got more left over for each star that twinkles in the blue. Pearly shells from the ocean, shining in the sun, covering the shore. When I see them, my heart tells me that I love you more than all the little pearly shells. For every grain of sand upon the beach, I got a kiss for you, and I've got more left over for each star that twinkles in the blue. Pearly shell from the ocean, shining in the sun, covering the shore. When I see them, my heart tells me that I love you more than all the little pearly shells, more than all little pearly shells. All right. Pick your favorite. Burl Ives, Don Ho. Pearly shells. All right. Oh, and that's sad. That's the last song of the night. Let me look back in. Again, tonight I was really bad about looking at comments. I was so distracted by Liz Brinker's talent that I didn't look at comments. Then I got distracted by the drum machine and I didn't look at comments. And then I got distracted by the looper. So a lot of distractions tonight. Thanks, Liz. Just kidding. All right. So let's take a look. Oh no, where'd everybody go? What does that mean? Oh, shoot. Did we lose? Wow. Okay, are we back? Chat continues, no Greg singing. I don't know if this is me or if it's just the internet going on. We got 55 people back. Yeah, all right, so give me a quick yes, you can see this. Because that's our second hiccup of tonight. Thanks, Rose. All right, well, it's our last song. And we do Three Little Birds traditionally every night. We were stuck in a loop. I'm gonna look. There's a website that is available to see internet outages, because I think we're having some rolling internet outages. All right, so I won't talk anymore. We're gonna do this one more song and then we'll call it a night. So let me switch over to that. Good. All right, here we go. And let me take these out because I don't need these anymore. Don't worry about a thing, even the internet, 'cause every little thing's gonna be alright. Sing and don't worry about a thing, 'cause every little thing's gonna be alright. Rise up this morning, smiled at the rising sun. Three little birds pitched by my doorstep, singing sweet songs of melodies pure and true, saying, this is my message to you. The internet will be better next week. And back to F. Rise up this morning, smiled with the rising sun. Three little birds pitched by my doorstep, singing sweet songs of melodies pure and true, saying, this is my message to you. Don't worry about a thing, 'cause every little thing's gonna be alright. Sing and don't worry about a thing, 'cause every little thing's gonna be alright. Rise up this morning, smiled with the rising sun. Three little birds pitched by my doorstep, singing sweet songs of melodies pure and true, saying, this is my message to you. This is my message to you. This is my message to you. All righty. Well, apologies for that. I do not know what actually happened there. So sorry to kick you off and then have you come back. I'm really sorry. We try to have a smooth show here. Want to say serious thank you to Liz Brinker. Also, Michael August and Franco Long that helped out with that collaboration video. That was a lot of fun. Check out Liz on YouTube. Just a lot of fun to watch. Liz, thank you so much. Everybody for coming on, just thank you. And I really hope it was a enjoyable 90 minutes or so. I hope that was a good break from your life. Anyhow, I had a story to tell you about ukulele people, but we've gone long enough. I will tell that next time. I thought it was funny. So anyway, take care and have a great week. Be safe and be good. We will see you next Wednesday, 7 p.m. Eastern. Tell your friends. Have them join us. All right. Good night, everyone. Take care. Bye.